Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about different sampling methods and ways to get your subjects for your study. The big picture about statistics is that we have a huge population, or it doesn't have to be huge, but it could just be everybody in a high school, or it could be everybody in a country, or it could be everybody in the world, or it could be all the trees in a forest. Whatever your population is, that's your large sample. And so your sample, you try to produce data by grabbing a part of your population. And that part of your population is your data. That's the data that you're using. And you explore that data and do analysis on that data. And then you make inferences for the whole population based on that. And that's probability in there because there always is a chance that your sample doesn't fully represent your population. But your way of sampling makes it more likely in different ways than others. So the goal is to select a representative sample from the population for cost-effective data collection so that inferences can be drawn about the population it comes from. So again, we take a small part of the population and we call that our sample. And that's the data we use to make decisions about the larger population. I want to remind you of a couple of terms is when we talk about a parameter, that parameter has to do with the entire population. When we talk about a statistic, that has to do with just a sample of the people. So if we have a parameter, that means we know about the whole population. If we have a statistic, we're talking about this is what we found for our sample, which we use to make inferences about the population. But sometimes you might be able to look at the entire population, especially if you want to talk about, you know, the cows in the one farmer's, you know, field, and there's 75 cows. You might be able to look at every single cow, and you don't have to use a statistic. You'll have a parameter. So those PPSS will help you remember that. So one way that we talk about sampling is to do a random sample. So for instance, if the members from a population are selected in such a way that each individual member in the population has an equal chance of being selected, that's a random sample. So let's say I have 15,000 people and I'm going to draw 9 names. And I have my hat, but it doesn't hold 15,000, so I put 5,000 in the first hat, 5,000 in the second hat, and 5,000 in the third hat. And then I say, well, I want 9 people, so it seems fair to take 3 names out of this hat, and 3 names out of this hat, and 3 names out of that hat, and that will give me my 9. And everybody in this whole 15,000 population has the same chance of being drawn. They have a 3 out of 5,000 chance in this hat, and a 3 out of that 5,000 chance, and a 3 out of that hat. So everybody in the population has the same equal chance of being selected. That's what makes that a random sample. But another type of sample that gets confused with that is a simple random sample. And in a simple random sample, everybody has to have the equal number of chance of being drawn, but also it has to be selected in a way that every possible sample of the same size n has the same chance of being chosen. So here's the thing. Let's say that you and 10 of your friends were all in the first hat. There's no way that 9 of you and your friends could ever be drawn out of this random sample method. Because if you're all in the same hat, the most that could happen is you and 2 of your friends could be drawn, right? But if you had a simple random sample and you put all 15,000 names in one big hat, now you and your friends are all in there, and they're going to draw 9 names out of that one big hat, and then those 9 names, now you have a chance of all being, you and 8 of your friends being selected, right? But that's not even possible up here in the random sample. So a random sample, everybody has an equal chance of being selected. But in a simple random sample, every possible combination of people has the same chance of being chosen. And just for one more time, I'll say it just for clarity, because this is something that gets confusing for people. If I draw out of one big hat, then I'm going to choose 9 people, and they all have a chance of all the different chances are the same for those 9 people to be chosen. I can get 9 people so many different ways. But up here, I can only get 3 from each hat. which means anybody who's in a hat together, there's no way to get that kind of a group. So this random sample, everybody has an equal chance of being selected. In a simple random sample, all groups have a chance of being selected. We haven't limited the way the groups are being chosen. Okay, have a fantastic day.